some examples of quality and personality defects. As you can see, I'm sure all of us would like to have all these qualities which are positive. To be calm and composed, to have humility, to be hardworking, patient, responsible, impartial, expansive, reliable, encouraging others, and be organized. And you can add many more as you want, which are positive. We understand, we would like to be. How many of us can think back and say, oh, I wish I was more organized. I wish my children could get more responsible. Or my boss could be more responsible. He's always passing the work on to me. Or to be patient. You cannot get, everybody wants to make a fast buck in one day. It doesn't happen in one day. As we say in banking, there is no free lunch. No, everything is paid for. But we think you're getting something which is free. Fact is, no, it's not like that. You have to have patience for the rewards. And some, we all have some or the other personality defect from any of these within us. And at some points, at some part of our life, it manifests in different forms. It could be anger. And I think today, whenever if anybody who travels by train regularly, everybody is sitting on a volcano of emotions. You just do like this and you're pushed and you know, that's how people react. Jagado, literally. Or any public transport. Anger, pride, laziness, impatience, irresponsible, partial, self-centered, and that's increasing in organizations also. Unreliable, criticizing others, and being unorganized. Now these are some of the defects which may be within us as well, in different degrees. Somebody may be highly unorganized. Somebody may be highly unreliable. You give him a time, he will never be on time. You give him, he will come, you don't know, you cannot depend on him. You do your own thing. So therefore, these are the personality defects which we face. Ill effects. The more PDs one has, there is more stress on that person's mind. And all of us don't like to be stressed out. And as you saw in the first slide, we are like that camel carrying so much baggage. We don't even realize we are carrying that baggage. And therefore, stress leads to worries, irritation, and waste of mental energy. I can say for most of us in this room, by 6, 7, you know, we are highly tired. You give, very few will be energetic to do new things at 7 in the evening. By the end of the day, we are finished. We just want to put up our legs, watch TV, go, have dinner, and go off to sleep. So, why is that? Because it's not physically maybe you have been doing something. The farmer out there is doing much more. But the fact is, it's that mental worry which is eating away and taking away our mental energy. And that is what we need to fight and move on to a positive sphere of understanding your own self. Due to this, not only our work, but our family and social life also suffers. I'll share an example. Yesterday I was leaving to go for a meeting. And I had my laptop. And I had one of my colleagues who had not finished what I was... I had to carry the report with me to my client. And the fact was that when I started carrying, I forgot to take my laptop charger in that confusion. So obviously I was more upset when I went to meet them. I had carried the report, but what I wanted to show on the laptop, and my laptop battery was completely low. So it only had 15 minutes of charging left. And I was scared that if I am not able to show, I was going all the way to Ghatkopar from here. So obviously it would have taken so much time. I mean, I was obviously upset. Why did this happen? And I'd forgotten my charger. I said the purpose of me going all the way from here to Ghatkopar and back is going to take away my entire energy, the time which we have committed, the client's time which was there, because it's very difficult to get through, to meet, to match the common time for us. And at the end of it, the purpose for which we were going would not be met. So therefore, you realize how much of time goes. And when I sat back and I analyzed, I said, it just meant that I had just had to be calm at that point, to just remember to carry. So much confusion happened in that half an hour that I said it was not worth the effort. And it happens, these incidents happen to all of us at different points. So when we look back, you realize that you have caused so much of waste of mental energy. And that frustration of, oh, I could have done this better, I could have done this better, I should not have said this, and so on. Unable to talk, unable to chant properly, because of that, my chanting became low. I was not able to chant. Normally, I would have chanted on the way. But I was only thinking, oh, I hope I've done this, I've done this. All work-related thoughts. Therefore, I was not able to concentrate and go peacefully when I'm going for a client meeting. Unable to talk to others nicely, because there was difficulty by others to understand our thoughts, as we find it difficult to understand each other. Communication became a problem. When I took out my laptop over there, I started struggling to find from my bag the charger. And that's when I realized that there was no charger. So I got even more irritated. So instead of being really nice to the person sitting in front of me and trying to understand what he is thinking or what he wants, I was only thinking, why did I forget this? Why I started blaming it on somebody else. And that's how all of us go through different ways, different incidents, different cycles. Outcome of whatever spiritual practice we do, also our capacity reduces because we are not able to fully utilize the time and resources. And in addition to that, obstacles are also created at various stages. Now let's come back to, therefore, having understood the importance of removing the defects which we have, what does one need to do? And that comes now, the camera is on you. So therefore, you have to understand, first, it starts by observation and identification. A lot of us may not be even aware we have this PD within us. You know, typically, biggest problem starts with having an ego. And we say, oh, this is an ego problem. And how many of us say this? Oh, I don't have an ego. I don't have any ego problems. That itself is the beginning that there is an ego. So we have to understand ourselves first on that account. And that requires a little bit of observation and identification. And then we go into analysis and what is the solution related to that. Observation may happen in the following ways. By realizing our own mistake, if someone else tells us our mistake, and when someone else's mistakes are discussed, we should also check to see if we have committed the same mistake as well. So therefore, it's very, very important. One is to understand your own mistake. If you've made a mistake, yes, we realize at times that yes, I, you know, especially when you're driving, you miss a signal, you know you made a mistake. We may not do anything about it, but there is a mistake which we have committed. If there's no cop, we are lucky, but the fact is it was a wrong action on our part. The second is you must have a lot of gratitude for somebody who's telling you your mistake. Are we graceful enough to accept? Of course, the intention behind the mistake which is told to you is very, very important. It should not be told to you with a lot of hatred or with a lot of vengeance. It should be told to you in a loving manner. And who can help in that is only our near and dear ones. And that's the one we don't listen to. Or somebody who's with you day to day, who understands you well, your spouse, your family members, and so on. And that is where we have to give lot of gratification to them and listen to them. And when I say listen, it means listen. Because he or she is actually telling you your mirror. And the mirror cannot lie. So the fact is, if somebody is saying, oh, you're always getting angry, or you're not listening, you're not doing this work properly, what we are doing is actually, we are getting an insight into our own self. And that is actually what is taught to people in the MBA school through communication styles in different forms. There is a concept called the Johari window. If anybody wants more information, you can go on the website. It will actually tell you a lot of details of how you can use this very effectively. And that's what we do. We have a session which we call a mistake session. Whenever we've had a meeting, after that, at the end of the meeting, we devote 5 minutes and we tell people, please tell us what I did wrong. or what you felt I could do better. We are always open to that, to feedback being received. Because that helps us, one, to stay humble, and second, it also helps us to improve ourselves and work on our defects even much more. So we say a lot of gratitude to the opposite person who's able to share your mistake. Because we can't see how we are behaving, but the opposite person can feel, understand, and therefore they can give you a better insight into your own self. Mistakes can be broadly categorized as wrong action or you have a wrong reaction. And we'll see that further. We've given this chart. This will help to understand what are the steps which you can use in identifying your mistakes. Now, step number one is over here, where someone tells us our mistake. Number two, we realize our mistake. Number three is we realize our mistake during the act. And as you can see, this is before and this is after. It's important to know as you progress that whenever a wrong action has taken place, were you able to control it before you started doing that action? Because you realize it's a wrong action. Now, as I mentioned to you, a lot of us have this habit of skipping the light. You see, in the evening at 9:30 on signals, junctions, there's red light. How many of us would stay there? And there is no cop at 9 o'clock, but after 9 o'clock we don't cop, and we find that there is really not much of traffic. Immediately we move on. We won't wait for anyone. We will just drive out. Drivers, if you're on a two-wheeler, you drive. You see a lot of cases like that. And I learned this from one of my ex-colleagues, who said, and he was a British. He said, "You Indians, you're too bad." And I learned this and I always hold this with me. Because he said, when you all see a cop, you all will stop. But when there is no cop, you all will all look around like this. And the way he said it, you know, you all will all look around like this and you all will run. And see what is an impression a foreigner is getting. And I'm talking way back. This I've heard back in 92. So when I heard this, that still remains in our mind, that see the impression how people are, we think. And the fact is, we are like that to some extent. I'm not saying everybody is like that. The fact is, are we really looking of our value systems of what we claim so much about? You know. So therefore, we realize that, yes, we have committed a mistake at the end. It's such a simple thing we do. It's not causing harm to anybody. And anyone will think, oh, how stupid, at 9:30 in the night, why should rush? So the fact is, yes, but the red light is meant for something. So, sometimes you realize after the mistake has happened, but if you start realizing as we progress, before the mistake is committed, you're about to get angry, you're about to shout. We all know when anybody is about to shout, what we say, say up to 10 or say up to 50, count up to 50. It brings down anger. What was the he said? Was because we know that it takes time, our mercury goes up and it goes down also. So fact is, next time when you're about to feel angry, you will start becoming aware and remain calm. And that's what we learn and we practice in the sessions which we do. How to remain calm even when you start recognizing your anger, when you're about to become angry. After the act is committed, it's before the act, or when it is about to get committed, is when you start becoming aware. And you put a control or put a brake at that point. So we realize this mistake. And as you move from here, we start off over here, you will slowly move before. And when you come till here, you'll realize at a lot of times, things have changed and you won't even realize this. And believe me, it does not take very long to change the way we think to handle our own defects. Be honest about owning the mistake. Reason out why it happened. you know, you've had a fight, you've had some argument, you have disagreements, either at work, at home, with friends, in meetings, in public meetings. Find out why it happened. Go back. Why did you scream? What happened at that time? And you will find that there is a PD which was lacking in us. For example, you'll realize any of this. There are simple things. People just tell lies for no reason. Simple things happen. Oh, I didn't do this. Very simple. Tell the boss, I'm not at home. Or if somebody is in the office, the boss will tell the subordinate, tell him I'm not in the office. This is a very common thing. It will not make a difference whether he is there or not there, but just tell him like that. But when we start doing this on a regular basis, you start realizing that what is that thing which makes you feel by saying that, oh, tell the client I'm not there. Why do you say that? Because you want to feel self-important. You want to prove that, oh, I'm busy. So see the premise, see the root cause which is causing you to say that. And that is the crux. That is the main reason for us to understand. It is that feeling of being wanted, feeling of getting recognized, which is what we have been craving as we have been from our childhood or from our previous births. When you have, how do you study your mistake? Is you can study the mistakes analytically. When you've written down that this is a mistake or this is a defect, or this is what I should not have done, then you study your mistakes analytically. When a mistake happens, see if it was pointed out or you realized or if somebody else realized the mistake. Think first, how I could have handled it differently. Maybe in another situation, you could have done something else and so on. Think about the impact it had on yourself and on the family, on the working environment you are in. And if it is the family, if you have young children, it is very, very important because they lead by example, not by what we teach them. They will see and they will do exactly what we do. Find out reason, and as we say, turn the camera on self. It helps to become introverted. Devise plans at an action and intellectual level to avoid repetition of such mistakes. I will show you something. This is what you can actually put it into practice of how you can do. What we do is on a regular basis. It is like writing a mirror of yourself. In the day, this is the diary which we maintain. And through this diary, it tells us what are the different ways of how it manifested, our PDs manifested in the day. Now, as you can see, you write the date, this could be any date which you start doing this. You write the wrong action or the reaction.